Hi friends, welcome to Competitive Exams Material channel. In this video, we are going to see Scala, okay, lists in Scala collections. So list is nothing but it's a type of collection. So in this tutorial, we are going to see how to create a list, how to add elements to a list, and some of the important operations that we can perform on the list. So first, let's define what is a list. I mean, even before going to the list, first let's define what is a collection. A collection is nothing but it's a container to hold multiple values. Okay, a collection is nothing but a container. Suppose if we take a variable, we can hold only one value. But if we want to hold multiple values, in that case, we go for a collection. There are six types of collections in Scala. Out of that, list is one among them. So first one is list. Let's see what is list. Okay, so list is similar to array. It is similar to Scala array. But the thing is, it is immutable and represents a linked list. These are the only two differences when compared to array. So list is immutable and list is recursive. List is recursive and it represents a linked list. Okay, so these are the main two differences when compared to array. Okay, even array holds multiple values and the list also holds multiple values. So these are the two differences between array and list. Let's see, how do we create a Scala list? Okay, in a simple way. Where L equal to list of 1, 2, 3. So this is how we define a list. So list is a keyword in Scala. Okay. And by giving the values like this, 1, by giving the comma separated values, we can create a list like this. And how to print the values in the list? Just say println of L. So println, just pass this list to the println method, which will print the values in the list. Let's run the program and see the output. If you see here, whenever you are printing, we are getting the values of the list. Okay, this is the simple way to create a list in Scala. And if you see here, we are creating an integer list. Okay, we are creating an integer list. We can also create different types of list by specifying the type here. So suppose var list colon list string equal to list of A comma B comma C. If you see here, by mentioning the type also, we can create type list, different types of list by mentioning the type, like integer, string. Okay, by mentioning the data type, we can create a list specific to that data type. Suppose if we want to create a string list, we need to give var l1, okay, colon, list of, give the type, which type you want to create. Since I want to create string type of list, I have given string here. List string equal to list of a col a, b, c. Let's print this. Println L1. Println of L1. Let's run the program and see the output. List of A, B, C. This is how we create a type list. And so these are the different types of ways to create a list and print the list. First way is like this, by just giving the list of 1, 2, 3 without mentioning any type. In the second way, we are mentioning the type. And the third way is by using cons operator. By using cons operator. So how the cons operator looks? It's nothing but it's a double colon. Okay, by using double colon. So this is how we define val a equal to one double colon, just give the braces, two double colon, three, and just mention nil. Nil is an, okay, nil means the last element. So 1, 2, 3, it's nil is nothing but it's a kind of empty as well. So if you want to create a list by using double colon operator, we mention like this. Okay, now let's print the elements of A. Let's print the elements of A. If you see 1, 2, 3, you understand? So these are the different or three types of ways to create a list in Scala. So these are the three different ways to create a list. Let's see some of the operations, how to get the first name in the list or first value in the list. For that we can use head. What is this? For that we can use head operation. So just call println of a dot head. So what a dot head will return? It will return first element in the list. Let's run the program and see the output. If you see, what is the first element in this list? 1, 2, 3, 1 is the first element. If you want to check in this, okay, what is the first element? A. Let's copy this and call l1.head. Let's run the program and see the output. So first element in the list is A. So we can use head, okay, head operation to get the first element in the list. Next one is, if you want to get, okay, all the elements except the first element, in that case we use tail. So what is the operation? Tail. So println of tail elements of the list and just call a dot tail. Okay, a dot tail. Sorry, just remove this upper answers. Okay, when we say a dot tail, it should print except one, it should print the remaining elements. So if you see except one, the rest of the elements are 2, 3. So it has printed 2, 3. Now if you see, if you are printing, I mean, if you want to print the tail elements of this L1, what should we do? Okay, we should call L1.tail. So what would be the output? It will skip this first element and it will print B and C. Let's run the program and see the output. L1.tail. So it will print B, C. Okay, so head is used to get the first element and tail is used to ignore the first element and print the rest of the elements. Next, we have a method called isEmpty which will return true if the list is empty, otherwise it returns false. To check whether a list is empty or not, what should we do? We should, okay, check whether list is empty or not. For this, what we need to do? We need to just say a dot is empty. Okay, so it will return a boolean value. What it will do? It will return a boolean value. So it will return true. Okay, if the list is empty, otherwise it will return false. Let's run the program and see the output. Okay, why it is returning false? Because A is not empty. A is not empty. Let's see how do we concatenate two lists in Scala. So in order to concatenate the list, we can do it in three ways. Okay, so first, concatenating list. This can be done in three ways. Okay, first one is by using triple colon operator. Three colons will be there. And then second one is list dot colon colon operator method. Okay, this is the second one. And the third one is by using list dot concat method. So if you want to combine two lists or join, I mean to concatenate two lists, what we use? We can use either of the three ways. Okay. Let's see the first one, how to concatenate two lists. Now we have, okay, two lists, L, L1. So how do we concatenate these two lists? Well, L3 equal to L:L1. Okay. Now just say print ln of L3, which will print the elements in this L3. Okay. L:L1. This is the first list and this is the second list. What is the first list? It contains only 1, 2, 3. What is the second list? It contains A, B, C. If you want to combine these two lists, how do we do? By using triple colon operator. Let's run the program and see the output. If you see, 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. Okay, this is the first way. And how about the second way? Well, L4 equal to L dot. Okay, we need to use this triple. Add the elements of the given list in the and then say L1. Let's print L4. And run the program and see the output. If you see ABC 1, 2, 3, it also concatenate 2. But the main difference between this, okay, triple colon and L dot triple colon L1 is, okay, you can simply see the output and get this. So if you see here, we are concatenating this ABC and then 1, 2, 3. What is this ABC and 1, 2, 3? So this is how ABC and 1, 2, 3. ABC and 1, 2, 3. So first it will add the elements of L1 to the L. So when we say L dot triple colon L1 means it will add the elements of L1 and then it will add the elements of L. Okay. Now let's use the concat method and find out L dot concat. Sorry, not L dot concat, it's list dot concat method. List dot concat and just pass the two lists. What are the two lists? L, L1. So these are the two lists. Okay. And then print the elements of L5, which is list 5, which will have the concatenation of both L and L1. Let's run the program and see the output. If you see, it is 1, 2, 3 and ABC. Okay. So these are the three different ways by which we can concatenate two lists. Hope you understand how to concatenate two lists. And then next, in the next one, how do we create uniform list? So this is also one of the way. Create uniform list in Scala. How do we create uniform list in Scala? We have a method called fill. Okay, this method will create a list and fills it with the element whatever we are giving there. Suppose val, I'm just saying f. Okay, and when we say, when we use list.fill method, okay, just say list.fill method, and here we need to give the value and the number of times. Okay, value equal to list.fill of 7, comma, okay, just give like this 7 and then value like this. Okay, 7 and 1. This 1 is the value and this is the frequency. We can call it as number of times or number of occurrences, we can say. So now when we say list.fill, it will create a list and it will copy this one element in 7 times. Okay, if you want, we can see the output as well. Println of f. Okay, let's run the program and see the output. It will print 7. Okay, print 1 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, fill 7 and 1. 1 is the value and here it is the number of times. Okay, this fills the list with the 7 instances of integer 1. Next one is how to reverse a list in Scala. Okay, how do we reverse a list in Scala? So we can just call val rev equal to if you want to reverse a list, okay, l, just say l dot reverse, and just call println of reverse. Okay, l dot reverse. So whatever the list we want to reverse, just call reverse on that l and this, and just print this rebel. If you see, instead of 1, 2, 3, we are giving 3, 2, 1. Okay, this is how we reverse a list. How do we reverse a list? By using list dot reverse method. Next. Next operation. So next one is apply. Okay, next one is apply. So if you want to get an element in the scalar list by its index, we use apply. So when do we use apply? Get the element index, get the element by index in scalar list using apply. Okay, so now just call val a equal to l dot apply of second element, assume that val a equal to l dot, let's see, I mean a is already defined. Oh, okay, fine, that is the reason we are getting like this. Just call it as x. Okay, l dot apply of do, and just say println of x. Let's run the program and see the output. 3. Okay, if you see here list 1, 2, 3, it starts with the index 0. Okay, that is the reason it is printing 3. If you want to print 1, okay, just give here 0. It should print 1 here. I'm just writing a comment here just for the readability purpose. Get the element by index. it will say 1. And the next one is, if we want to check whether an element exists in the list or not, okay, if we want to check whether the element exists in the not, we can use contains method. This is the next operation. So what this contains will do, it will check whether element exists in the list or not. Okay, let's see the output. Okay, just call println and check l dot contains. So in the list, what we'll do, we'll check whether the element 1 is there or not, I mean 1 is present or not. Okay, so you see, this is the contains method. It tests whether this list contains a given value as an element or not. Okay, so it will return the boolean value if it exists, so it will return true. Let's run the program and see the output. True. And assume that if I am giving the element as 10 and this element is not present in the list, it should return as false. So let's see, now it is returning as false. So this is how the contain method works. And one more important one, next one. So this might be frequently used, how to get the length of the list. So we can get the length of the list, okay, by using length. Okay, by using length, we can get the length of the list. So let's run this println of length of the list equals to l dot length. Just call this length. So if you see here, so length is nothing but it's a function, okay, in the list. So it returns the length of the list. Okay, it returns the length of the list. So if you want to print the number of elements in this list or the size of the list, we can use l dot length. So the length of the list is 3. Okay. And the next one is, if you want to get the distinct, okay, if you want to print distinct elements in the list, in that case we have a method called distinct. First let's create a list. Okay, first let's create a list where list equals to list of 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 4. Okay. And then if we want to print the distinct elements, okay, we can use list.distinct. Okay, we can use list.distinct. So here is the list 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2. If we want to print the distinct element in the list, we can use distinct, okay, method. It builds a new list from this list without any duplicate element. So what is the purpose of distinct? So it builds a new list by removing the duplicates. Okay, let's run the program and see the output. You see, here we have the duplicate elements, but after calling the distinct, we are getting the unique elements from that list. Hope you understand the element, how to create a list, and some of the important operations in the list. Thanks for watching this video. If you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.